A very good morning, my dear students. So we are doing squares and square roots. Now, what is a square? Square is the raised integer is 2, and square root is the raised fraction, that is 1/2. I have shown it here. This is square, this is square root. They are opposite to each other. Okay, let's start with question number 6. In question number 6, you are given a square whose area is 441 meter square. Now we have to find out this side. What is the side of this square? All right. Now we know very well what is the area of a square. Area of a square is side into side. So this is same as 441 meter square. Now what is side into side? Side into side means side square 441 meter square. So and what is side then? Side in this case will be 441. The raised fraction will become 1/2, because this 2 when goes this side will become 1/2. So that is m square into 1/2. Same thing. This 2 will become 1/2 here also and here also. So now what does it mean? This is nothing but the square root. And this 2 to cancel, so it will be m. So we'll find out the square root of 441. Make pairs. Last start from here. 4, 1 is already paired, but 4 is not paired, so I'll write it 0. So 2, 2 is 4. This 2 will become double here. 4 minus 4 is 0. Only 41 will come down. So 41 into 1 is 41. Alright, this thing we did yesterday. So you can do it. So what is the square root? Square root is 21 meter. So therefore the side of the square is 21 meter. Clear? Okay. After this, question number 7. Please have a look. Once again, side into side is 441 meter square. Find out the square root of 441. That will give you the side. That is 21 meter. Now, question number 7. In question number 7, you have a right angle triangle where AB and BC is given. AB is given as 6 cm and BC is given as 8 cm. You have to find out AC. What is AC equal to? Now, in this case, AC is equal to AC square plus AB square plus BC square. Now, this is called Pythagoras theorem. So what is Pythagoras theorem? Pythagoras theorem is applied to right angle triangle. It means square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of squares of other two right sides. So therefore AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Now we'll just put the values. So AC square means AB square, that is 6 square plus 8 square, yes, centimeter square. So AC will give me now, see, I'm directly writing this 2 will come this side, the power will become half. That half is nothing but the square root. So same thing I'm writing it here. 6 square is 36, 8 square is 64, this will become centimeter. So the square root of 100, that is 10 centimeter. So 10 centimeter is the answer for AC. Alright. So this is what question number 7, the first part. Second part, please try yourself. If you have to find out AB, what you will do? You will subtract BC from AC and then find out the square root. Okay. I think easy, not that difficult. Now let's do question number 9. Question number 9. In this question, you have got 500 children, and this 500 children has to be arranged in equal number of rows and columns. Now, this is possible on if and only if the number is a perfect square. Let us see whether number of students that is 500 is a perfect square or not. let us find out square root. 2 2 is 4. This 2 will become double here. This 2 zeros will come down. Okay. Now, if I write 3 here, 43 into 3, it will become 129. 129 is greater than this, so I will write 2 here. So, 2 is 84. I mean, 42 into 2 is 84, so 16. This is not a perfect square because we are getting a remainder. That means this 16s are extra. So, how many students have to be removed from 500? We have to remove 16 students. Let me read the question once again. There are 500 children in a school for a PT drill and they have to be arranged in equal number of rows and columns. How many children would be left out in this arrangement? If they have to arrange this 500 students, how many children will be left out if they have to arrange in equal number of rows and columns? The answer is 16. Clear? Okay. Now, we'll start with exercise 6.1. Now, 6.1, the very first question is very easy, very, very easy. You have already done this. Once again, I'm just giving a revision on this. 6.1, question number 1, you have to find out the ones place in the square of 81. What would be the ones place if I square this number? Answer is very simple, 81 into 1. So 1 into 1, the ones place will be ones place. Or let me write unit digit. They are writing unit digit, so let me write unit digit. So unit digit will be 1. Unit digit and 1's place meaning is same. So 1 into 1 is 1. If it is 2 here, suppose it is 82, then 2 into 2, 4. Clear? Let me take one more example so that you should not have confusion. Let me take this example, third one. 799. I mean this is 709. Square is there. Now see here, 9 into 9 is 81. So unit digit will be 1 because 9 into 9 is 1. If it is 1, 2, 3, 4. This was the third part. Let me take one more example that is of fifth part. 1, 2, 3, 4 square. So 1, 2, 3, 4 into 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 into 4 is 16. So 6 is the unit digit. Clear? Okay. Now after this, question number 3, I am giving as a homework. Question number 3, 4, 5. Try this yourself. You can do it. Now question number 6. Now question number 6 is based on pattern. The pattern is like this, 3 square plus 4 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. The next pattern they have given as 5 square plus dash plus they have written 30 plus 31 square. The next pattern is 6 square plus 7 square plus dash dash. Now look here my dear students, 3 into 4 is 12, 12 plus 1 is 13, so this is 13 square. Similarly, 3 into 4 is 12, 3 is increased by 1, that is 4. Similarly, 5 will increase by 1, that is 6, so 6 square will come here. In this case, 6 is increased by 1, same pattern, and 6 into 7 will come 42. Why 42? Because see here, 5 into 6 is 30, 3 into 4 is 12. So here it will come 42 square. And this 30 has become 31. That means this 42 will become 43. So 43. Increase, multiply, you will get this one. Increase this by 1, you will get this one. This is the pattern. Okay. Now after this, question number 7. This is, I'm making a revision, okay, because we have already done this before. क्वेश्चन नंबर सेवन. क्वेश्चन नंबर सेवन इज लेट मी टेक द सेकेंड पार्ट. द सेकेंड पार्ट इज लाइक दिस. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 19. You have to find out the sum of all these odd numbers without actual addition. So how to find out? Let us count how many odd numbers are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 odd numbers. So answer will be 10 square. So answer is 100. Clear? Means you see the how many odd numbers are there. Remember, this should be the consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. It should start from 1. So 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 and so on. 10 square. So you will get 100. Instead of writing 10 square directly here, let me write 100 first. That will be better. So now this is nothing but 10 square. Clear? So what does it mean? When we add the odd numbers, the first, let me put it this way. When we add first 5 odd numbers, starting from 1, remember it should start from 1. First 5 odd numbers, the answer is 25. Because first 5, so 5 square. Here first 10, so 10 square, so 100. Clear? Now after this, question number 9, that is the last question of the exercise. And question number 8, please try yourself. It is just opposite of this. Question number 8 is opposite of this. Question number 9, that is, you have to find out You have to find out the numbers. Between these two squares. You have to find out how many numbers are there between these two squares. Now, the answer is 2 into 12. Answer is 24. There are 24 numbers are there between these two square numbers. Remember, if it is consecutive, it's very easy to find out. Like 12 and 13, these are two consecutive square numbers. It's very easy to find it out. What is the formula? Suppose you have n numbers and then you have n plus 1 numbers. They are consecutive numbers. See, n plus 1. It is increased by 1. 12 is increased by 1. So, n plus 1. So, numbers lying between n square and n plus 1 square is equal to 2n. Okay, numbers lying between n square plus n plus 1 square is 2 numbers. These are numbers. So same thing is here. So n is the smallest number. So 12 is the smallest here. So 2 into 12 is 24. Therefore, total number. You can just write total number here. Is equal to 2 into 12. If it is 25 and 26, then 2 into 25. If it is 36 and 37, 2 into 36. Clear? That will give you the numbers. Okay, my dear students, I did my best to cover up all the 4 exercises. There might be some problem, I know, and please practice every day again and again. If any problem, please send me the question or call me. It's better that you call me and remind me. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.